Hello everyone, and it's Chuck Thunder, and we're back for episode 2 of our Let's Play series of Farming Simulator, and all you've missed so far was me bringing my tractor over here with my new trailer and dropping off that lime that I bought, and I cut down a tree and began slicing and dicing it up. Now, normally I'd say I need something to load this truck up with to pick these up, because without super strength, I can't pick this up, but let's just say I had some hired help. I think that makes sense, because obviously I can't pick up every branch, but some I can. And if I really wanted to, I could cut them to sizes that are appropriate and do so, but I don't know that it's necessary. So, for one log, it seems to be the case, just about one log, I'll load you up with one humongo log. Right now, get a second humongo log. So this is what we're going to be focusing on today while this finishes up, is getting these trees cut down. We'll continue to do this work while that happens. Might be able to get this whole tree down to the logging area. And our time here. So long as this tractor doesn't have any major issues with transporting this kind of length, because that's one thing I've run into, is that when it gets longer, these trees, especially these curved ones, they have issues with being able to actually take these longer ones, because they like get snagged or something and cause the trailer to do some wonky things. So I'm hoping I don't have that problem with this trailer. I might have to make a second trip. Just because this is a small trailer and I don't want that to happen. It's not that far away. I might lose this guy. Gotta be careful. There we go, now it's all done. Alright, so where we're going is actually right across this field, straight across. And it's barring no problems, we should be able to sell this, no problem. I'm just trying to make some money while I wait for some of that stuff to finish, the seeding and all that stuff. So there's 6 logs loaded at 2.9 tons. So let's see what we're looking at here. Now this is not going to give us a ton of money because it is an odd shaped tree. It's not a pine tree, but I want to clear that area out so I can fill it with equipment trailers and buildings and things. So, with that being said, let's get our butts over here and see what this sells for now. I had one issue with the going over these railroad tracks earlier in the test run, getting snagged up on them as I go over. So hopefully this doesn't be a problem. Alright, looks like we made it. Let's park our tractor. $3,000. Not bad. You know what? While we're at it, let's go ahead and record. I'm going to have it fall on the grass way here, because if this is ever a situation where we need to buy this field and use this field, I don't want it to be run over by path to go drop this stuff off. So let's get our butts back to the house. Load up the next load and continue our auto drive. Nice little tractor, guys. $8,000. Really low power output, but just enough to do some basic stuff around the house. Other than that, I'm going to still be pushing it over the field. That's fine. Log path. recording. Let's go ahead and start loading you up with more logs. I probably won't get 3,000 bucks for this one, but it's a lot less logs and a lot smaller logs. I'm just rushing it. I don't normally load logs like this. I normally load them in, yeah, like this direction first, and lay them nice and flat in the bottom, but because these things are curved and funky. I'm not quite getting the fit that I wanted, but it is what it is. Should have got one of the big ones first. Okay, get our straps done. Can I do it from inside? There we go. Record. Real close. Hopefully I don't have a problem with that path later. Get another couple thousand dollars at the most, maybe here. Yeah, I've noticed that a lot of these trees on this map are not something you can cut down, whether you own the property or not. I'm hoping that with some of the property that I bought has more to sell than just these trees, otherwise we're going to have to take a loan to buy some property that has trees so we can cut the trees down to make money to pay back our loan, so. Alright, made it over. And stop here. Stop recording. Connect, name, we'll call this lumber mill, create, back out, sell for $1,000, and we say go back to the log path. I made it. Here we got some air. Alright. Looks like you're about done with this half. We're just going to stop you now. See if I can polish off this edge. I don't have to get wall-to-wall coverage on this, but like 6 liters, 7 liters of seed this way. We'll do the other side later. It's not even the end of the first day, it's still midday. Started. Alright, so that first tree is done. This next tree ought to be a lot easier to cut down. So it's a lot thinner of a tree. Pine trees also work 1,000 times better than those stupid ugly trees that are all shaped all funny. Just walk down the whole thing and boom, freeze cut. And then all we have to do is cut it to size. So I like to lay it next to the trailer like this. Get it to the length of the trailer. Maybe cut it a half a length longer than the trailer. I'll lay it like that. Move the thing down. Same idea. Cut it at length. Load it up. Easy enough. And then this one should already be close enough in length. And if it's not, no big deal. It'll just make it disappear. And I'll just load you up with the remainder. Easy enough. Now, we have another one over there. I might try to take that one. They got some big trees. These guys, this right here is a Mondo tree. We'll take down the other palm tree first. Because I think it might be an issue with doing this field seeding wise. So, we'll cut this down first. Remove the stump. This is what the lumberjack mod lets you do too, is cut down the logs with a chainsaw rather than having to get in a stump grinder. This is the best I typically go. Okay. Get a strap on you. And then let us cut down our first of these trees here, these big Mondo ones. Turn it this way so the tree falls that way. Alrighty, get rid of the log. I notice this won't work as well, but we're gonna do our best. We'll cut a few of these off. And the tree fell on our tractor. Alright, I want to load these up like one limb at a time because there's only so much that I could fit in here, and you guys aren't going to want to see me cutting trees up forever, but this is what I like to do early game, in especially seasons when you've got plenty of time to cut trees down in between seasons, so you might as well do some of this while you have work being done by hired help. Uh-oh. Alright, we're gonna have a problem. This is another reason why I like auto. This is not gonna work. Not gonna work. We're gonna have to do it another different direction here. Let's have it seed the other way. I think I noticed that happening across the way. I had a feeling something funky was happening. Why are you backing so funny? Holy mackerel. This is what I mean. It's like this happened sometimes, all because of some funky ass, like, invisible tree shit. Come on. Fixed it. Nope. Trees. apparently still attached. Alright, well, we're gonna go get rid of this load then, while this is behaving like a complete bonkers. Happening. I don't really think it's actually working. Yeah, I got one lung that's not even like resting on the tree. Maybe resting on there, but whatever. See if that fixes our problem. Once we unload these logs. And that seems to be working, so while that's happening, let's go ahead and cut up the rest of this tree. They fill up the trailer quite a bit. Sweet. What are we honking for? What are we honking for? Let's go, Steven. Come on. What's blocking it? Really? That was blocking it? He wasn't even in the road, like, ever. I still don't think so. Jeez. People, man, they don't know how to drive in Indiana, do they? This is why I like Indiana, though. It's nice and flat. You can see for miles. Alright, so we have... I'll sell that too, I guess. Alrighty. My tractor almost back. It is. Okay. Let's load up. This works well. Good thing first. These are the big boys, let's go. What? Guys are so big, I don't think we're going to be able to fit anything else in here. With at least not having some major concern about it tipping the trailer. We may really make these bottom portions of these big red trees really, really heavy. Oh, see, this is what I mean. Things like this happen. I don't understand what it's struggling with. Before. You know, the moment we can upgrade it in this trailer, that's what we're going to do. Because now I need to babysit this trailer. Because you never know where it's going to just jackknife itself out of nowhere. Alright, so this tractor is doing us fine. This trailer is doing us fine. As soon as I cut down all these trees in the area, I'm considering maybe investing in a pickup truck that has interchangeable beds. I like the idea of that because then I'll have extra storage in the back of the truck for trailing, you know, bringing things back and forth. It really depends on the purposes and how much money you have here and how much money I'll make off of these logging of these trees. I mean, I made like 10 grand off these trees so far. Alright, looks like we're gonna have to just drag your butt. Yeah, you might call this cheating, whatever. I call it fixing a glitch. Yeah, that was a nice good chunk. I feel like it was so heavy. Alright, back to cutting these trees. What do we got left here? We got a couple of small nuggets. Okay, we'll cut down a few of these. We'll drag these over. Get these nice and trimmed up for the trailer. Hopefully we can fit all of this in there. Looks like we are on a roll with this log cutting business. Definitely a long process of log cutting. So, I'm not much of an editor of videos. What I would say is, hey, you know, I'll check in with you once I finish a lot of this work, but. You don't need to see that, you know, that's really not necessary for me to cut this off. Maybe you like to see this kind of work being done. Maybe you don't, you know. I'm not, I don't have the time to edit the videos today. I got my nephews over, so I'm just trying to get the work done on the field while I can and get video recorded. So if you want to see it, be my guest, come and watch. Hopefully this log thing stays in there. It's going to be like, what, $2? Oh, look at that, strapped on. Alright, what else can we get on here? Maybe get one more branch on. That'd be nice if we get one branch on. Probably gonna get more, but again, I don't like to overload these trailers because, as you saw, when you put a lot of weight on it, it jackknifes itself. All right. Alright, we're off to a good start. Why are we missing spots in the middle of the field? Helpers, man. Helpers. You're not helping me any, really, if you're missing spots.
Valuable time lost.
But this field's almost done. And we still haven't even used, like, anywhere near all of our wheat seed and anywhere near all of our fertilizer, so we'll probably be able to top off and maybe even start seeding that field over there. goal, but is to have 2 week fleets that I can do hay baling with, and sell the hay bales. I've never really worked with hay before. I mean, I've always done hay bales, straw bales. I've always done straw and then sold it immediately in vanilla, but I've never done straw before in seasons. And from what I'm told, is that in seasons there are places to sell things that are specific to the seasons. Like if you look at the sell points here, like okay, so wheat we know we could sell in two different places for potentially two different prices when that season comes around, canola, all that stuff. But then as we scroll down here, notice it says grass, grass, hay, and straw. There's like no prices here, and the Buckley Farm doesn't accept any of it. Well, it doesn't, but there are places that do, and I have to find those places, and I'm not entirely sure where those places are. So I might spend some time off camera on this map on another save, trying to figure out where to sell straw bales. So something I might consider doing soon. I'll figure out sooner rather than later, because it'll be 6 days and we are going to have fully harvestable fields in 9, and I'm going to have to be able to figure out what to do with that straw. I mean, in the off season I could sell it, which is great, but I got nowhere to go sell it. So thanks for guys checking in again. We'll be having a good old time continuing to log. I'm going to log off camera for a while, continue to make 22 grand to 3 grand a pop as I do as much logging as I can to get the money flow going and to make some space for some stuff on my fields, you know, buildings and other things as I earn the money. So I appreciate everybody swinging by, and if you could leave a like or a comment in the description, and we'll get started and make the series another one of those good ones like I had last time. I really do appreciate everybody coming out and watching these videos. I appreciate all the support. It's been your boy, Chuck Thunder. Take care.